Okay, so today, class 2, week 3, we continue. Basically, we finished today chapter 1, Leoa, regarding semiconductors, occurrence junction. Okay, these are the main topics. Very important. These are the basics. The foundation of the foundation. The foundation of the foundations. And the fundamental of microelectronics starts with this. If you miss this, you will miss everything after that. Class? Very important. And that's why today's quiz is in that direction, to put you in the track of understanding what will follow. Class? So, let's keep going. Okay. Any question before I start? The quiz will be solved and we put in the blackboard, okay? We'll create, inshallah, a folder for all the quizzes. Solutions, okay? So that you have solution. You will see also grade distribution. And as I've told you, units are counts, everything counts. Understanding is very important. If there is a clear understanding, it will be rewarded. For those who just think that it's easy to fool the instructor with any answer, I advise them not to do that, because the understanding will be clear in the writing. And when we write, we'll be accountable for that writing, not for our intention. You understand? So somebody comes to me and say, listen, instructor, I wrote this, but I mean something else. It doesn't count. I've seen that some students do that. Doesn't work. You understand? You know why, right?
Yes.
Khalas. Then only God knows what's in your intention. He can give you the grade. Me, I cannot. I don't see that. Okay? You understand? So I have to be fair with everybody. What I see is what I grade. Class? Clear? Good, let's go. So, let's go to page 64. The solution is there, by the way. But I will go with you here just to show you how to solve. It's the best way. We call this the methodology. Tariqa. Or, in other words, al-tariqiyya. Then masdar. Okay, methodology. Okay? So this is how we do it. Okay, first we read. Consider a forward bias p-n junction. As I remember, I have p-n junction, good. Forward bias, voltage is?
Positive.
Positive, good. So, and then, conducting current of this point, 1 milliamp. Good. If it conducts, it's because it is forward biased. Remember the video?
Yes.
You said that the current is very small, so almost is nothing. So that means, yes, we are in forward bias. Good. With the following parameters. These are the parameters that we know. NA, ND, A, blah, blah, etc., etc. We're not going to read that. And as you can see, the units are in red. Because they are important. If you make mistake in the units, the result also will be wrong. Okay? That's why it's so important, the units. Again, remember, 5 eggs are not like 5 watermelon. خمسة بيض. مش زي خمسة بطيخ خمسة بيض in one hand I can put them صح ولا لا but خمسة بطيخ ولا بطيخ أنا أقدر نشيلها واحدة صح ولا لا let alone 5 good so let's calculate the first thing is IS what's IS
saturation current
what is the nature of this current is it a drift ولا diffusion
different.
Very good so the type the nature طبيعة of this is drift current what's the name
Saturation.
The name,
Yes.
Like us, we are humans. Tabia. What's our name? Wallahi, Dr. Faisal, whoever, and X and Y, Z. Come now. Understand? Very important. Now, how to calculate IS? Of course, it's very hard to remember this. So, I have to provide you with the equation. And what's that equation that we need to use? Is this one. Okay. This I have to provide it. All these have been explained, and they are given. What they are given is a problem. All what we need to do is just apply calculator. Of course, we have to watch the units. I can change the units and make it difficult. So your task is to make sure that all these units are, they are يعني, canceling each other somehow. For example, method DP is a distance. So LP and DP should have the same unit. Do you understand?
Yeah.
Everyone understand? For example, if DP is I give it to you in micron and LP in meter, so automatically what you do is either use them both in meter or both in centimeter or micron or whatever. Do you understand? Do you understand?
Yes.
So if you use unit for something, it has to be for everything of the same nature. Okay? Same thing for MD. If it is per meter square cubic, use meter cubic. But here, you see, here this per meter cubic. This one in this case must be in meter and this in meter, so that they will cancel out somehow. You understand? So all distances, wherever there's a distance, should be the same everywhere. You understand?
Yes.
Whether micro, centimeter, whatever. Okay? Halas, that's it. So the units, they all themselves, they need a whole class. And now, this is very easy. Just to play around with that, and that's it. So we're done with that. I'm not going to waste my time to calculate this. You can do that yourself at home. All right. Now, the second question is, calculate the forward bias voltage. How do you find this one? Let me use it. How do we find this one? Can somebody tell me?
I equal.
The question, did you understand the question here?
Yes.
So, how to find the forward bias voltage?
From the equation of the current.
What is the equation? Says what?
I equal IS.
E
to the power of V.
E to the power IS. It's IS here.
Yes.
Sorry about that. So saturation current. And then IS here. Okay.
E to the power V over VT
minus 1. So we can do something here. We can say that the current, is quite bigger. It's relatively big. 0.1 milliamp is not very small because this is 10 power minus 10 or minus 12. Sahalala? So it's so big compared to this one. Milliamp 10 minus 3. Sahalala? So 0.1 is 10 minus 4. Compared to IS, who are 10 minus 10, wallah, 10 minus 12 hatta, okay? So big. Yani you can neglect this guy. You can say it's okay. Because exponential make this one so big compared to this one. Do you understand?
Yeah.
Understand? So in this case, it'll be easy to find. Okay, if we ignore this, if we say goodbye to the U, and in this case, I will do what? I will do this. I will delete it completely. Okay, and get this off. Okay, and then I just make this guy E to this. So in this case, from here, what I get?
V
is equal.
Yes.
What do you think?
Len?
Wait a second, Tamada. We want participation of the whole class, huh? Yes, the mother, I'll come to you.
I over IS.
I over IS,
then take the
len.
The
len.
For the both sides.
And then?
Then divide by VT.
Divide. What do you mean divide? This?
Multiply.
Multiply. It's not divide. Multiply.
Multiply.
Yes. Multiply, yes or no? Do you get that? So, then, very good, the mother. VT, logarithm or len, like you said. I over IS. Done? We calculated IS.
Yes.
Do we have I? It's
yes.
Given. It's given. Yes or no? What is that? 0.1.
Yeah.
VT, we know VT. How much is VT?
K V over
I. Just a second. We did not mention here the temperature. Sah wa lala?
Yes.
So we assume this is another rule. If we don't give you the temperature, we're talking about room temperature. So in this case, T, how much?
300.
300. 300 what?
Kelvin.
I see the units are very important. So in this case, at 300 Kelvin or at room temperature, VT, how much?
26.
Very good. You can take it 26 or 25 millivolt. That's fine. Either way, I will accept. Khalas, that's it. So this one, let's say, this one is a 26 millivolt. Khalas, no problem. This, the unit of this is what?
It will cancel.
No.
Nothing. There is absolutely nothing. There should be no unit inside the logarithm. If I find a unit there, that means you are wrong. Fam too?
Yes.
Okay, well, unit of the logarithm is also nothing. So that's why there's a voltage here and a voltage there, you see? So what? So my equation is correct. And then I will replace this by 0.1 milliamp, remember? And this one by IS that I calculated here. And that's it. We find the volt. Okay? Good. So now, the last one. Component of the current. So the question is to find the component of the current due to hole injection and electron injection across the junction. How we find this?
By the equation of IP.
IP. How much is IP?
IP is
Let's go back. That's fine. Let's go back to IP. Let's go to the currents. That could be a good idea. Okay. Now, as you can see here, she said a very good point here. See here, this A times JP will give us what?
IB.
Very good. And JN times A?
IN.
IN, no, JN times A. صح ولا لا?
Yes.
And this plus this give us what?
Total current.
The total current. This one is the one that we already talked, which is IS e power V over VT. صح ولا لا? We know I, yes or no?
Yes.
Very good. So it will be easy then. We can calculate IP here. Boom, boom. And we can calculate. But again, it will be tedious too. It's very hard. Now I have to get PN0. We don't have PN0, do we have? I don't think we have. We're NP0 also. We don't have. But I can calculate. And it's fine. Hatta we can use not use this one. Hatta we can use even this one. Let's say here we can take this one. This one, see this one? This one. Also we can call it what? IP. صح ولا لا? IP, yeah. And this one, let's see. Yeah, yeah. Okay, good. And this one multiplied of course with this one.
IN.
IN. Yes or no?
Yes.
Khalas. And IP plus IN, boom boom. Khalas. We have everything here. صح ولا لا? We should not do it this way.
Doctor, can we multiply it with A to the power of V over V?
Yeah, of course. With both of them, they have to be multiplied. Hey, yes.
Okay.
That's correct. Yeah, she mentioned a good point. It's actually both of these, they have to be multiplied by this to find IP and IN. So, this is a very good point, okay? I missed that. Now, the best way is not to do this. The best way, which is found also in the textbook, is actually to divide IP or IN over I, one over the other. Why? Lenu they share what? They share this. Sawalala. And they share this. What they don't share is these. Do you understand?
Yes.
So become easy. So now, here I can find this. Easy. Sawalala. So I have one equation. The other equation is what? So this is equation number one. The other equation is IP plus IN is equal
I.
Sahu alala?
Yes.
So two equations with two unknowns, can we solve it?
Yes.
Easy or not? So this is the easiest way. You understand? This is the easiest way. Is to make the ratio Y, because I don't want to keep repeat this, multiply the others, this and this, multiply this and this. So I just make the ratio to cancel these so that I don't have to repeat calculation. And then with just that equation and the other equation that we know, it'd be easy to find the solution. Clear? See? Some play with mathematics make our life easy. Okay, good. Any question? No question. Okay. Let's keep going now in the with the course. So finish the notes? Finish?
Yeah.
Alas, we move on. I think in the textbook also is explained like that, but I'm trying it to make easy for you, okay, to understand. All right? So let's keep going. All right, so we finished that nice example. All right? That's good. We start, or we've tried to finish today's class. What are the remaining things, sir? The remaining thing, which is also important, is the capacitance. We said that the depletion region is like what?
Capacitance.
Give us a name of capacitance in Arabic.
Mukathif.
It's like two plates. One is positive, one is negative. Then it must capacitance. Actually, it's not capacitance, it's capacitor. Mukathifa. Al capacitance is khasiyat al mukathifa. It's like a resistance.
Resistance.
A resistor. Understand? So, resistor wa ism al-shay, and my resistance is the quality of al-shay. Can you say it? Now? Good. So, we start again with two conditions. We start in the reverse bias, we find the capacitance of this capacitor, which is the junction. It's not a capacitor, but it has capacitance. مستعملوش كالكapacitor, do you understand? Well, it can have the capacitance خاصية ليش? Then when we use it in the circuit, we have to use the capacitance feature. Okay, so that next time, don't tell me that it's capacitor. No, it has capacitance. عنده خاصية capacitance. بس هو بحد ذاته كاباسيتر؟ No, it's not used as capacitor. But later on, you can see that some of the applications will use this capacitance of the junction in a very nice way. So, in the first case of reverse bias, remember this equation. What's this? What's this?
Charge.
Charge of what?
Density.
Charge density.
Let's see.
This is a density. Square root. Okay. Now this is the. This is the junction charge. Okay. This is not the density. It's the charge stored in either side of the junction. If you go back and try to revise, this is the basically the charge. What is that? Let me draw something here. So let's say this is the P-N junction. This is our junction. Halas. This is P, this is N, okay? And there will be a depletion region where in here, on the side of P, what we have charge?
Negative.
Always flip things, then things will become easy. So negative. And on the side, we have the positive. Don't have them, to memorize. Just flip things and things will become easy. So this is our, basically, capacitor. So basically, Q junction here, it's either the total charge here or the total charge here because they are what? Equal in absolute value. Mm-hmm. This is just negative, this is positive. Remember that? Remember? Very good. So that, either this charge or this charge, the value of that is this equation. And you remember, in the reverse bias, here we have to add to the voltage. We add to the voltage. And we add the absolute value here. Don't add the negative value, otherwise we are subtracting.
Yes.
So if we reverse bias by 1 volt, now it would be 1 plus V naught, because it will increase the depletion region. You understand? Good. Sah. Thank you very much, sir. Now, what is the capacitance? If you have a capacitor, how you calculate the capacitance? C is the capacitance. I will follow someone. Okay, wait a second. Whoa, easy.
Q
somebody, whoa, easy. Left, yeah, easy, yeah.
C equal?
Yeah.
Over V.
C equal what?
Q is number of charge over the V.
Very good, thank you very much. So that's what we are looking. So C is equal to the charge over the voltage. The charge of the capacitor divided by the voltage of the capacitor.
Yes.
Boom. Now, this is in the case of a capacitor that is normal capacitor. Ma'ruf, two plates, boom. Okay? Now the problem here, this capacitor is not so normal. Why? Because if you look at the charge here with respect to the voltage, here, this one is constant, so we don't talk about it. This one is the one that changed, yes or no?
Yes.
So if you look here, as we increase this guy increase. Sah wa lala?
Yes.
So now the problem, the relation between the charge and the voltage is what? Is nonlinear. لا خطية. This one here, if I write here this equation differently, I will write what? I will write Q is equal to C times V. صح ولا لا؟
Yes.
So Q is equal, yes or no?
Yes.
Correct? So this relation, the capacitance, when we buy a capacitor, the capacitance is the constant number, or does it change? It's constant. One microfarad,
yes.
It gives you exact number when you go and buy it. If you go to the lab, there's a constant number. So that means Q, the charge stored in the capacitor, is linearly proportional to V. يعني العلاقة بين charge and voltage خطية. Linear. The voltage increases, the charge increases. Understand? Yes or no? Good. So the question here, the junction capacitance now is actually non-linear, is actually square root of that. Do you see that? So we cannot apply this equation. We cannot do that. Why? Because this equation comes actually from the original equation, which unfortunately was not taught, is actually the derivative of this with the derivative of that. What does it mean? It means if the charge change a little bit, it will create a change of a voltage by a little bit. And if you divide this little bit by that little bit, it will give me this the capacitors. That's the definition. This is the original definition. It's the little bit over little bit, the differential equation. No? That's the exact equation. It's like the speed. It's not the distance over the time. It's actually change of the distance over the change of time. When I can do the distance over the time, it's only when the speed is constant. Then in this case, the little bit or the whole distance is the same over the little bit of time or the whole time. Do you understand? Mm-hmm. So that's the idea, okay? So this is the original. This is the right one. We can apply it in here, and it will give me the same answer, like the capacitor. In any case, so now we know what to use. So we come to this equation, and we do what? We do the derivative of the charge with respect to the voltage. The voltage that is controlling this charge is Vr, not V0. V0 is constant. It depends on the doping. It depends on Ni. Remember that? And it depends on the temperature. If all these things are constant, V0 is called is constant. Very good. So, we take that. Thank you very much. But before we do the derivative, we try to write this equation in a smaller way. So, we can write Qg, the junction capacitance, as a constant alpha, which is the whole this. So, this is what?
Alpha.
With alpha. Why we do that? Because we are lazy. You know, engineers, they don't like right. You are breaking our head. Alas, we throw all this and put it in the name of alpha. Later, if I want to know the value of alpha, I just go and replace it. Clear? Very good. So now we have a nice equation, which is alpha. Then what remains here is the square root of Vr plus
V0.
Sahalala?
Yes.
Good. Boom, boom. That's it. So now it's easy to make the derivative, yes or no?
Yes.
Because alpha is constant. Mm-hmm. All these are constant. Because the only thing that changes is this guy. Very good. So now I make the derivative. I get what? I get this equation. But when I do the derivative, I do derive this function and evaluate it at a certain voltage, Vq. Send me a Vq. A certain given reverse bias voltage. That's it. We get this equation. Now this is the result of the derivative. Very good. Thank you very much. What do we do next? We say, okay, thank you very much. Now let's replace the voltage. What's the minimum value of Vr? Is zero.
Yes.
Sahalala? Because that's the minimum value of Vr. So let's replace Vr with zero and see how much. So we call that the junction capacitance at zero bias. It means when there's no connection. Khalas fil hawa. Okay? That is very important. Okay? So if we replace Vr by these, by the value of zero, we get this value. Hey, thank you very much. I can come here to this derivative. And then we try to take alpha over 2 square root of V0 and take it out. If I do that, this is what happens. Okay, this is what happens. So if I take alpha, let's follow me, yeah? So if I take that from there, what do? I take it from where? From this equation, huh? So I take alpha, so alpha is here, and I take 2 over 2, and I take what?
Square root
of
Vr.
No, I want to take square root of Vr.
Okay.
Khalas? Follow me, yeah? So times lena, it will be 1. Sahalala? Alpha? Bam, bam. Sahalala? 2, you take it out. Now, square root, now. So I take basically Vr from here. It will go out with a square. Sahalala?
Yes.
So it remains here what? 1. Sahalala? And Vr, I take it from here.
V0.
Remaining here what?
V0
over Vr. Yes or no?
Mm.
Make sense? Make sense or no? Did you get this?
Yes.
Very easy. Who did not get it? Want me to repeat?
Yes.
Repeat?
Yes, please.
Good. So, no problem. So basically we take Vr from these two. If I take Vr as a common factor, so here remains what? 1. Follow me? Did you see that? If I take Vr from here as a common factor, I'm a mushtarak. Here remains what? 1. Here, see. We have what? We have square root of Vr plus V0. We are talking only about the square root. Huh? We took alpha and 2 out. Okay? So what do? I do this. Vr times what? Here remain what? 1. Sahalala? Vr times 1? Vr. Plus what? Plus V0?
Over Vr.
Over Vr. All of that under the square root.
Yes.
Square root of multiplication, we can split it.
Yeah.
So square root now of VR go out. And what remains is 1 over V0 over VR under the square root.
Okay.
Do you get it now?
Yes.
Clear? It's okay to repeat. If you don't understand, do not use the mobile only in the class. That's all what I ask you, okay? Some people are using the mobile, so please stop the mobile, put it aside. This is last one, okay? Good. So very good. So we are in this relationship because what did we say about this constant? Which one? This one, we call it, we have, it has a name, it is CJ0, the junction at zero bias, the junction capacitance at zero bias. So now I can take this, which is this, and give it the name of CJ0. Boom. It will be over the square root of this. Got it?
Yes.
That's it. So let me now delete this. These are all math. So it's not really big, complicated math. Very simple math. Good. So now this is the equation. We call this equation is the capacitance, the junction capacitance, and the reverse bias of the junction. But with abrupt approximation. What means abrupt approximation? It means that the concentration, abrupt junction doping concentration. That means what? That means here, if I look at, who are the dopant here? Who? Who are the dopant?
Holes.
No, the dopant. Who makes the holes here?
Acceptors.
The density is high, yes or no?
Mm-hmm.
And it creates here. And then here, usually we said the acceptors is more than the donors, yes or no?
Yes.
That's the usual case, that's fine. So here, and here the donors are here, yes or no?
Mm-hmm.
These are the donors and the, and these are the acceptors
and
A.
Yes.
Now, in the abrupt junction doping concentration, these guys, they meet abruptly here. It means goes from up and then go down. In real life, in the fabrication process, this concentration actually changes smoothly at the edge. Means that goes, oh, I have to use a blue. That's better. Sorry about that. The blue, where's the blue? Let me use the blue. So this concentration of the acceptors here actually decrease little bit by the junction, and then it will meet the donor's concentration. So the change of the doping agent, if you want, or the dopant, is actually smooth in fabrication, in real life, it means. Okay?
Mm-hmm.
So this smoothness is opposite to the abrupt. Abrupt, it varies very quickly, very rapidly, like dum, dum, dum. That's it. This is a smooth thing, and that smoothness makes this capacitance change. By how much? By a certain power m. So instead of using this equation, which is this plus this power half, we will use the same equation, but here in the denominator, we'll use a power m. Okay? Why? Because in real life, we don't have abrupt junction. We have smooth junction, and that m change actually from what? From the value of third, means 0.333, up to half, which is 0.5. And the unit, it has no unit. And it's in the power. You understand? Clear? That's it. So that's now we found the junction capacitance. That's it. So it does change non-linearly. Now, you're done with this? We move? Okay, let's move on. If we plot now the junction charge with respect to the voltage, as I've shown you, it's non-linear. And the slope, the slope. Why the slope? The slope is the junction capacitance. Why? Because if you remember, C is equal to the derivative of Q with respect to the voltage.
Yes.
This is nothing but the slope.
Yes.
Then the slope is the derivative of Y with respect to X.
Mm-hmm.
So the slope of this line, of the tangent here, will give me what? The capacitance. As you can see, the slope will decrease. And it becomes almost flat. In very high reverse bias. Indeed, does make sense. Why? Because if you go back now to that formula, if VR goes increase, what happens to CG?
Decrease.
Decrease goes down. Hamda? You understand?
Yes.
So that's what it is. Like here, graphically, we are explaining graphically how to get basically the slope. That's it. And the point where we need to measure the capacitance, we always call it the bias point. You understand? It means where we bias it, where the voltage is. No, that's it. Handy. Graphically, very clear, very easy to understand. It's called the junction or depletion capacitance. This in the case of reverse bias. Yes or no?
Yes.
Now we get to the more little bit spicy capacitance, which is the case of forward bias. Then when the reverse bias is very easy, this charge equal to this, and we... Now in the forward bias is a little bit spicy, but it's not that of difficult. So in the forward bias, we said that the holes, they will move in a diffusion manner from the p-type or the anode to the cathode or the n-type semiconductor, and they will increase the minority there, okay? And the same thing for the electrons from the cathode to the anode, and they will increase the minority on the other side. That's it. Now, to calculate the capacitance, I have to calculate what? I have to calculate the charge. Yes or no? Mm. Very good. So in thermal equilibrium, everything was canceling each other. We don't have excess. Now, in the case of forward bias, we have extra charge, which is what? Which is the charge under this curve. The charge under this curve, which is what? QP, yes or no? And the charge under this curve is above the equilibrium, which is this one. I will call it QN. QP on this side, QN on the other side, they will make what? They will make the capacitor. Now, to calculate QP, we do the integral then in this case of this function, صح ولا لا? From this point to infinity or to the end of the junction. So the junction is like this, if you will. Okay? This is the depletion. The W, depletion region, XN, XP, bye bye. This is the junction where it is right now. This is the N type here, yes or no? And this is the P type. And everything would be smooth. Now, when you do the integral of that, of QP, you will find after certain calculation, I don't want to waste your time or my time there. You can check that in the textbook. You will find that QP, which is that charge on the cathode side, is equal to a certain constant, which is LP, the diffusion length of the holes, squared over the diffusion constant, DP, times IP, which is the current of the holes. Yes or no?
Yes.
So this is one. Now, this is the thing. Now, I want to do something here. There is a comma here, okay? So that you don't make a mistake. So this is the value of QP. So this, now this is what? This, which is this one, if you look at it, it has the unit of time. Yes or no? Why? Because the current is the charge over time. And here I have a charge. If I have here a charge, and this is a charge over time, this must be what? Time.
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 Yes.
Must be time. Yes or no?
Yes.
That time we call it tau p. Remember, this symbol means tau. We read it, it's a Greek symbol, means tau. It's like lambda or beta, alpha, blah, blah. This one we call it tau. For those in physics, we use tau a lot for time, to say t. Very good. Of the holes, we call this tau of p, we call it the minority carriers, which is in this case the holes, lifetime in the N region. The same thing like in the diffusion length. Now we don't talk about the distance, we talk about the time. It's like the average time of a hole to exist without recombination in the n-type. From now, when the holes diffuse from here to there, they will take certain time before they will recombine. You understand? Some of them, they will be long, some of them very short, but the average is what? Is tau p. It's the same like the diffusion length. Some of them, they will diffuse all along. Some now, they will reach until here. But some of them will be dead right there. So the average between there and there is actually LP or tau P, either a distance or a time, okay? It's a little bit complicated, but it's not that of a complicated issue. So now, I can write, or they could write, QP now, we can write it what? Tau P times IP. The same thing for the QN, because they are very similar. Just one is positive, the other is negative. So I can write QN here, after doing the integration as well. We can write, and you can find that tau QN is equal to tau N IN. The same definition. Now, in this case, again, the physicists and engineers are crazy sometimes, but it's not that crazy. Now I can, now what I need to do, I have to add QP and QN. In this case, the total charge of the, you know, the junction in here is QP, which is tau P IP, plus QN, which is tau N IN. When I do that, I can say what, hey, listen, I will rewrite this equation, rewrite it in a nice way, again, because we are lazy. We can write it as tau T, another time, times the total current. Because I know IP plus IN is equal to I, the current. So I can, you know, rewrite this in a different way, which is tau T I. That's the total charge of the capacitance. Now, tau T will give it another name. We call it the mean transit time. The mean transit time is very similar to the minority carrier lifetime in the N region or the P region. So something like an average between the two. Okay? Very good. Now, the problem is, it's very hard to find tau T here. I know tau P. I have the value, yes or no? And I know tau N also, by replacing this by N, this by N, I can get also tau N. But tau T, I don't know what is it. It is in function of tau T, tau P and tau N, but they don't know exactly that formula. So what do? We make approximation. Means, for the majority of our applications, we will dope the P region more than the N region, meaning NA will be more or higher than ND. In this case, what will happen if you look here, NA much bigger than ND, what will happen? What will happen is that the hole current will be bigger than the electron current because of this. If you compare, if you go to those formula, let's go back. Just a second. Okay, 1 second. Let's go back a little bit. What did we say? If you see IP and IN, NA, we said, is much bigger than ND. That means this will be smaller, yes or no?
Yes.
Which one is the smaller?
The IN.
The IN, صح ولا لا? Do you understand? When NA is much bigger than ND, this makes IN much smaller than IP. Do you get it?
Yes.
Clear or not?
Yes.
Clear. Very good. So we go back now to that. Okay, to that equation. Just to make approximation. So now IP, if IP is much bigger than IN, that means the current is almost equal to IP. Then IN is very, very small. Yes. So we can ignore. Bye bye. So in that case, I can say then in this case, tau T is almost, then is equal to IP. So tau T equal almost I tau P. Then no IN is gone. Hada is gone. So now if you compare the tau to the tau, so tau P must be equal almost to tau T. Very good. Thank you very much. That's all what I need. Now I can, instead of tau T, I use tau P. But this is constant. Now if I make the derivative, because remember, the capacitance is the derivative of the charge with respect to the voltage. So I have to derive what? To derive Q with respect to what? To the voltage. So tau T or tau P in this case can get out. And I have to derive I with respect to V. Remember I is equal to what? It's almost equal to Is exponential V over VT. Forget about the minus, because we said that's, if we have a good bias, we can ignore that minus, okay? If you derive now, because here we have to derive, yes or no? The tau T get out, you see? The tau T will get out. So if we derive now I with respect to the voltage, so it will be equal to what? Is stay out, somewhere enough, and the derivative of the top will be 1 over Vt, yes or no? Are you following me? And times E over V over VT. Yes or no? Now this is what? This is the current. Yes or no? So when we derive this, so this means that the derivative of I with respect to the voltage is going to be equal to what? I divided by VT. Yes or no? Mm-hmm.
Yes.
Make sense? Following me? Are you following me or?
Yes.
After the quiz, we are dead. Khalas? Are you with us? Do you understand? If you want to repeat, I repeat. Huh? Is it clear?
Yes.
I will repeat a little bit. So we said that Q, now after this approximation here, I can write Q is equal to what? Tau P, then tau T is almost equal to what? To tau P, then IN is gone. Times what? Times the current. Now, to find the capacitance, I have to divide this with respect to the voltage, yes or no? This is constant, yes or no? Tau P is constant. Does it change with voltage? No. So I have to derive this with respect to the voltage, yes or no?
Yes.
That's the way, yeah? Correct? Now, when we derive I, this is what I did here. If you derive I with respect to V, boom, 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 you will find that the derivation of I over with respect to V is I over VT. This is math. I can do nothing about that. Tawalala? If you don't know math, this is not a course for math. Okay, clear?
Yes.
That's it. So I take this result and plug it where? Here. It will give me tau t over vt, that comes after under I, because it was here under I, yes or no? Vt. So I bring it under I, put it under tau t. That's it. So now what I do? So now the capacitance is equal to what? To a certain constant that depends on the temperature here, times the current. So if the current increases, the capacitance will increase. That's what it is. If the temperature increase, VT increase, VT. The thermal voltage, VT. We're talking about VT.
Okay.
Increase, then the whole thing will decrease. صح ولا لا?
Yes.
And this, the capacitance
will
go down. Do you understand?
Yes.
It's just a way how to understand the thing. Almost done. So this is a summary, and the remaining are also summary. I'm not going to read for you the summary. No? You will tell me you are wasting our time here, sir. And we have done for today's class and for chapter one. Eid Mubarak for everybody, okay? Enjoy your Eid, forget about the quiz, and good luck. Eid Mubarak. Salaam alaikum.